Good morning, students. In our today video, we are going to see in detail about melting point, boiling point, their other names, their use. Because in our last video, we have seen the introduction about it. And also in this video, we are going to end our chapter. And we are also going to see about evaporation. What is the cooling effect of evaporation?
Chapter 1, matter in our surrounding. This video is going to be the last part for this chapter. In our last video, we have seen the melting point. As in a very short way. In this video, we are going to expand it and see it in detail. So, melting point is a point at which solid start converting into a liquid. The other name for a melting point is fusion. Now, why it is happening? जब हम solid को heat देते हैं, तब वो ज़्यादा speed में vibrate होता है और free हो जाता है liquid में. All of this is happening because of kinetic energy. Because when we heat the solid, it increases the kinetic energy. And for doing that, we need latent heat. Latent heat is a hidden heat, means heat which absorbed by the solid to get converted into a liquid. So for this, we are going to use the word latent heat of fusion, because melting is known as fusion. So amount of heat energy required for 1 kilogram of solid into an atmospheric pressure is known as melting point. Ab iska matlab kya hua? 1 किलो के सॉलिड को लिक्विड में कन्वर्ट करने के लिए जो हीट चाहिए होती है नॉर्मल प्रेशर पे, नॉर्मल एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर, जैसे कि हमारा इस टाइम पे जो नॉर्मल एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर है वो 180 एम है, तो उस प्रेशर पे जितनी हीट चाहिए होगी उसको हम बोलेंगे लेटेंट हीट ऑफ फ्यूजन. सेकंड वन इज बॉइलिंग. बॉइलिंग मीन्स व्हेन लिक्विड स्टार्ट कन्वर्टिंग इनटू अ गैस. नाउ बॉइलिंग इज अ बल्क फेनोमेना. बल्क मीन्स अ लार्ज, means in this a lot of liquids boil together and start converting into a gas. So when we heat a liquid, its particles start moving faster because of the higher temperature, increasing the kinetic energy, and because of that they leave the force of attraction. Because of that they convert into a gaseous. The temperature for a normal water to get boil is 100 degrees Celsius. And latent heat for this is known as latent heat of vaporization, because boiling is a kind of a vaporization. Means boiling mein kya hota hai, pani gas mein convert ho jata hai, matlab vapors mein convert ho jata hai, jiski wajah se iski latent heat ko latent heat of vaporization bolte hai. Again this is same as solid. Amount of heat energy required for 1 kilogram of liquid into a gas is known at a atmospheric pressure is known as boiling point. मतलब एक किलो पानी को गैस में कन्वर्ट करने के लिए जितनी एनर्जी चाहिए होती है, हीट एनर्जी, एक एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर पे, उसको बोला जाता है लेटेंट हीट ऑफ वेपराइजेशन. नेक्स्ट इज सब्लिमेशन. सब्लिमेशन इज चेंज ऑफ स्टेट डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम सॉलिड टू गैस. मीन्स देयर इज नो लिक्विड स्टेज बिटवीन देम. सॉलिड डायरेक्टली गैस में कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा, उसको हम बोलते हैं सब्लिमेशन. Probably this word is new for you, but sublimation is happening a lot and lot of time. For example, camphor, ammonium chloride, also solid CO2, which is also known as dry ice. These all things do sublimation. They directly convert solid to gas, means they are not having any kind of liquid state between when they are changing state from solid to gas. And for this activity is given, as you can see in the diagram. By this activity you can understand it. Till now we have seen the effect of temperature on matter, but here we are going to see the effect of pressure on gaseous. Especially we are going to see on gaseous, because pressure means one type of compression, and compression doesn't work on solid and liquid. Therefore we are seeing it on gaseous only. So whenever you are going giving pressure or compressing gas, and also at the same time you are lowering down the temperature, matlab temperature kam kar rahe ho aur sath mein pressure bhi de rahe ho, at that time kya hoga, jo bhi gas hogi wo convert ho jayegi liquid mein. But sari gases aisa nahi karti hai. For example CO2 is a gas is directly converted into solid, and when you are heating it, it converts solid to gas directly. In a short means CO2 is not having liquid form. So CO2 in a solid is also known as dry ice, or you can also say it solid carbon dioxide. As you can see in the images, we have here shown the pressurized gas, and again we have shown the pressurized liquid, which is not able to get pressurized. Pressurized gas, example that LPG at your house. This is the interconversion of three state of matter into each other. Means solid to liquid is known as fusion as well as melting. Then liquid to solid is known as solidification. Solid to gas is known as vaporization, but gas to liquid is known as condensation. Solid to gas or gas to solid directly, it is known as sublimation. These things are important to learn, and also you have to write this thing in your notebook so you can learn it by heart. And this thing is going to come handy in our exercise. Next is evaporation. This is the last topic of our chapter, but one of the most important topic.
Now many of you are going to think evaporation as a boiling. Matlab evaporation mein bhi kya hota hai? Liquid vapors mein convert ho jata hai. But isme different hota hai. The main difference between boiling and evaporation is that boiling jo hota hai wo sirf boiling point pe hota hai, lekin evaporation har ek temperature pe hota hai. For an example, when you are making your clothes dry under sunlight, at that time there is not a boiling point of a water, but still your clothes dries. Matlab aap jab kapde sukhate ho tab boiling point nahi hoti hai, boiling point nahi hoti hai fir bhi hamare kapde to sukh hi jate hain. Boiling point ke bina jab bhi water convert hoga gas mein, us cheez ko bolenge evaporation. Now, evaporation is also known as surface phenomena. Surface phenomena means it happens on the surface of any cloth, water or anything. So therefore, it is also known as surface phenomena. Now, there are few factors which affect evaporation. The first factor is surface area. Second is temperature, then humidity and wind speed. When I'm talking about surface area, means when you are increasing the surface area, evaporation gets faster. How it works? Best example will be again when we are going to dry our clothes. जब हम कपड़े सुखाते हैं तो कपड़ों को हम खोल के सुखाते हैं, फोल्ड करके नहीं, उसको properly open करते हैं फिर सुखाने डालते हैं. Why we are doing that? Because folding clothes can't dry faster compared to the opened cloth. Means evaporation is surface area related phenomena. Means if you are increasing the surface area, speed of evaporation will increase. Second is temperature. Simple thing, in summer season clothes dries faster compared to some winter and rainy season. That means if increasing the temperature, evaporation will increase. Third one is humidity. Simple thing, again the same example, in rainy season our clothes dry very slower compared to a summer season. Why it is happening? Because already a lot of humidity is present in our atmosphere. Because of that, evaporation gets slower and they can't do as much as evaporation as they are doing in summer season. Last one will be the wind speed. You have noticed that whenever wind speed increases, evaporation will increase. Why it is happening? This is happening because when there is higher wind speed and wind is also hotter, at that time they get a lot of heat with the help of direct sunlight as well as wind, and wind also carries droplets with itself. मतलब wind क्या होती है, छोटे छोटे पानी की बूंदों को अपने साथ लेके जाती है. उसके अलावा अगर wind गर्म होती है तो आसपास की surrounding की गर्मी increase कर देती है, temperature increase कर देती है. Because of that, evaporation gets faster. Here you can see how evaporation works. Here I have make you shown one kind of you can say river or ocean. In that, a lot of molecules of water is present, which is H2O. Therefore, I have drawn two particles, blue and orange, that is H2O. Whenever we are giving heat, they start vibrating faster and they leave the force of attraction. And when they leave the force of attraction, they get evaporated, means they are getting converted into gas. In this way, evaporation works. Here I have shown you evaporation as per the energy. When high energy is there, evaporation make faster. When medium energy is there, some waters get evaporated and some again get back into a liquid form, means pulled back into a water. If very low energy is present, means you are giving a very low temperature to them, at that time it remains in liquid. Simple matlab, jitni zyada heat hogi utna zyada evaporation hoga. Heat is a kind of energy, therefore I have written over here energy. High energy, medium energy and lower energy. In this way you can understand why it is getting faster in summer, slower in rainy and slowest in a winter season. In this way we can understand how evaporation work as per the heat energy. Now evaporation also does the cooling effect. Best example of it, this will be our normal house coolers as well as pot. Now if you are going to see this, how it is working, liquid is absorbing the heat in surrounding and after absorbing it converting into a gas. Means heat is absorbing the heat from the surrounding. Agar heat absorb ho jayegi to kya hoga, cooling effect aega, jiske wajah se kya hoga, aas pass ki sara surrounding cool ho jayega. जिसकी वजह से हमको बहुत सारी चीज़ें ठंडी फील होती है.
बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इफेक्ट ऑफ इवोपरेशन, सो वेन यू स्प्रिंकल वाटर ऑन योर रूफ, इवोपरेशन हैपेंस एंड वाटर एब्जॉर्व अ लॉट ऑफ हीट एंड योर हाउस फील्स कूल. ड्यूरिंग समर स्वेट डज द सेम वर्क एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट अवर कॉटन क्लोथ्स फील अस मोर यू कैन से कंफर्टेबल एंड कूल कम्पेयर टू अदर क्लोथ.
ओके, ओवर हियर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर चैप्टर. यू सी एवरीथिंग पॉसिबल इन दिस चैप्टर. Now, regarding this chapter, I am going to send you a worksheet. That worksheet you have to solve in your science notebook. And if you are having any kind of doubt with worksheet or any kind of doubt in the chapter explanation or queries, we are going to solve each and everything in our online sessions. Thank you for watching the video.